Hi, I'm Carolyn Cable. Today we're in studio with Hollywood makeup artist Heather C. Howard. She's also a licensed esthetician, and we also have a beautiful model, Casey. You are here today to do a makeup look, a sort of a makeover, a mini makeover for home use. Could you tell us what your specialty is?
My specialty lies within making a person bring out their natural beauty. And it is generated toward just doing a natural, clean look without overdoing anything, but still giving the look of having a beautiful, flawless skin.
Oh, wonderful. And let me just tell you that our model is prepped and camera ready, which basically means that she started with the foundation. Mm-hmm. And do you have powder on her?
We have powder, we have some blush, and we have an eye base.
Oh, you do? Mm-hmm. Okay, so we have to still go over that.
We'll still go over them, but okay. Yeah.
How did you start with the foundation?
The foundation, you tend to need to look toward the neck color to get that to match. And sometimes a face will be a little bit darker than neck or vice versa. And you want to make sure that they match because you're going to blend down. So you never want to go with the natural color of your face or the natural color of your neck. You want to get that in between so it's a nice blend from top to bottom.
So if you're in a store or at a beauty counter, you would actually take dabs of it and dab it along your neck?
Dab it along your neck, dab it along the side of your cheek because that's tend to be where you get the different colors too, where you can tell the top to bottom. Mm-hmm. And sometimes a good indication is putting your neck with your arm up to your neck.
Could we see if you put your arm up to your neck? And this would be the match.
You would tend to want to go more the match that way.
I see.
You'd want to match the arm because that's where you're also darkest also.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, before we get into the makeup, I brought some department store makeup.
Okay.
And I wanted to ask you the difference between department store makeup and drugstore makeup, because obviously these products are very expensive compared to what they would be for mm-hmm. drugstore. And I have heard that certain brands like Estee Lauder owns Maybelline. Maybe it's not Estee Lauder and Maybelline, but I've heard that the big companies own the smaller companies. They just want, you know, to get the whole market.
Estee Lauder is the parent company to most drugstore brands.
Okay.
And the difference as far as buying drugstore makeup and buying department store counter makeup, really what you're paying for is a feeling. Because it's not so much that the products are that much different. Granted, there could
and
be a little bit
casing.
More. You're paying for the casing, which, you know, if you see something like this, you're going to want to pay a little bit more mm-hmm. to have something pretty in your purse or in your makeup kit as opposed to something, you know, from the drugstore, which is just plastic and clear and shows the color that you're buying.
Right. And then these usually also come with a nice applicator.
They do.
And
whereas the drugstore
a really nice
don't.
Mirror, right?
Mm-hmm.
So pretty colors. Are the makeup, the oils and things like that inside the makeup different, or
the chemistry of the makeup tends to be the same? There are slight differences, and wow. from brand to brand, it could be different. But the general makeup is about the same between a drugstore brand and a department store brand.
Wonderful. Okay, now pressed powder versus loose powder. Let me tell you a little quick story. I do a reoccurring role on Days of Our Lives. The head makeup woman, her name is Gail, and she's won all kinds of Emmys for her makeup. And we were talking about powder one day, so I was working a couple weeks ago, and I brought up again about the powder because I get my pressed powder from a famous Hollywood makeup store so that it you can wear it during the day outside, but you can also wear it on camera.
Mm-hmm.
And she had told me that you really don't want to use pressed powder, you want to use very fine milled.
Yes.
So she gave me hers, and I feel like, oh, wow, I have Emmy Award-winning makeup on. And this is, I'm not going to say the brand name, but this goes on wet. It has a wet feel to it,
mm-hmm.
and I mean, it's very light, so it doesn't cake on you, mm-hmm. which is very nice. And then it comes, obviously, with its own little brush, which you're going to have to tell me about cleaning brushes
Absolutely.
And stuff.
Absolutely, which is very important to do.
How important is it to have a loose powder and to have an expensive loose powder that's very fine compared to having...
The powder is generally where, if you were going to spend your bulk of your money, you mm-hmm. would spend on your powder. Because again, the powder consistencies are different. When you're going more toward a drugstore brand, those mm-hmm. tend to have a lot of synthetic, have a lot of petrochemicals, petroleum, a lot of mm-hmm. fragrance, as opposed to the types where you can get in a department store or at a professional beauty supply, makeup counter type place, where they have now generated more skin friendly as far as with the anti-aging and all the sun damage and the different types of complexions that people have that can make their skin either break out, get clogged pores. So that, if you're going to spend your money, I would say spend it on a decent powder.
Okay, great. Let's get into the look.
Okay.
Let's just step aside here. So this is your before. This is your before look.
Yes, this is a before. It's just we've got foundation, some blush, and a base eye.
Can you tell me why, just for the audience sake, why she has already has a little bit of blush on?
Just makes you prettier and feel good.
And also because of the lights. The lights are very bright in the studio.
Absolutely.
And so we didn't want the facial features.
And if we didn't have any type of color, it would just come across as flat and washed out. So we add a little bit of color. We will add more, but you just add a little bit just so that you don't lose the depth of the skin or the face.
Wonderful. Okay. Let's see. So do you model often in makeup chairs?
First time ever.
Oh, okay.
So first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our powder. You always want to tap out your brushes to get the bulk of the powder off so you don't go on and start streaking with a major clump of any type of color on your skin. And you smile. And you just go on the apple of the cheek, go up to the temples, bring it back down, do the same thing. Apples of the cheek, bring it up toward the temple. And the reason that you're doing that is you're creating a nice symmetry. That way it's not just color. It's blending. Everything about makeup is that you want it to blend. You don't ever want to see hard lines, streaks, or a definition of there's makeup. You see it. So everything is about blending. So you blend it up, bring it down, blend it up, bring it down. Same thing when you do foundation. It's very important, which most people don't do, is they stop their foundation here because they're like, why do I need to do my neck? That's one of the biggest misconceptions and mistakes that I generally see women make when I'm walking on the street. And also the ears. They forget their ears.
Oh.
Okay. Now, that the reason why you do that, again, is because your face has many different colors. You know, the forehead could be a little bit redder from the sun, your ears can be a little bit lighter, the neck tends to sometimes be a little bit red, so you want everything to be one even single tone color. You don't ever want to see color on your forehead, color on your chin, and then it just gets a little distorted. So everything about makeup is about blending. You want to bring it in, bring it down.
How important is this brush that you're using?
The difference with brushes is, and that's another area where if you're going to spend your money, spend it on your brushes.
Okay.
Because when you go to and get department store brushes, though, those aren't bad and they'll serve their purpose.
You mean drugstore?
Drugstore brushes. Okay. You know, they work, they serve their purpose, but they don't last as long and they're not as good of a quality of a hair. Professional brushes tend to use either Boar's hair or Sable, which is a better. And then with these
Sable
types of brushes.
Sable better than Boar?
Apples and oranges, whichever you prefer. It's just a preference. But these brushes, you also do want to make sure that you wash them consistently. And like with the brush that you were showing me, it's very important after at least, I'd say, three applications of using, you know, just run it under the water with either hand soap or the same shampoo and conditioner you use on your hair.
Now, that's interesting. I never thought of conditioning the brushes, but because it's hair, you would need to, and that's why it stays soft.
And it's what keeps your brushes soft. It's what keeps your brushes lasting a lot longer, is by taking care of it, washing it, shampoo, and then conditioning it, leaving the conditioner on for a little while to let it soak in and it... Because like normal hair, it can get split ends, it could start to come off, and that's why sometimes, you know, when we were working on you earlier, you saw that it was leaving little residue, tiny pieces of hair.
That's because it was from the brush.
That's because it was from the brush.
What about, you don't, you know, sometimes my brushes, after I wash them, I'll go like this and get it all out, but then they look frayed. You don't do that.
I don't do that
you
because
you just take
that
it out of the water. Do you pat it or not even pat it?
You know,
just
when I take it out of the water, you know, I tend to, when I put the, I'll put the shampoo in my palm, I'll swirl it around, you know, get it in, then I'll rinse it off.
Can you do that again to the camera?
Sure.
That's a great way to do
you
it.
You have a little dab of the shampoo that you're using, and then you get your brush and you just do in tiny little circles.
Great.
And then while you're doing that, it'll make the lather and it'll clean it up.
And then you do that with the conditioner?
And then what you do is when you want to make sure, too, that you spread it. That way, when you're rinsing it under the water, you spread your bristles so you can get all the soap out. You make sure all your soap's out. Do a nice tight squeeze where you hold and just push all the water out. Then you do the conditioner. With the conditioner, I tend to just lay it on, you know, rub it in. And then I'll leave it for 5 minutes and while I'm working on my other brushes.
Oh, great.
So then by the time I'm finished with my last brush, my first brush is ready to be rinsed.
Oh, great.
And then once you rinse off the conditioner, again, just squeeze all the excess water off. You can either do that by using your hand and just putting a little bit of pressure, or you can use a towel just to pat it dry and then leave it. Don't fluff it, don't open it, just let it dry.
Okay.
Because that way, by the time the brush is dry the next day, just apply a little.
And if you're like me, who has already, you know, gone like that to my brushes, is there a way to save them? They are expensive brushes. They're not the drugstore brushes, but I know that I've abused them by doing that. Is there a way to save that brush, or no?
You know, I need to get new brushes. Leave-on conditioner. Just do the same thing, you know, put some conditioner and leave it on overnight. Mm-hmm. Go back to it when you rinse it off and get all the shampoo and conditioner off the brush, just let it sit.
Oh, great.
Just leave it there and let it dry. You know, sometimes if you're in a hurry, or some brushes are meant to be a little bit more open, mm-hmm. I would even open it and just take a little bit of a soft blow dryer.
Okay.
And just with light air and just kind of blow dry it a little
bit. Thank you. She saves money too. Okay, thanks. So next up, are you doing her eyes?
Next up, we're going to go to eyes, yes.
Now, why did you start with her cheeks?
Tends to open up the face and give the face some more color, and then from there you can get a good idea of what you're looking to do next. It just
Great.
It helps bring the skin together, and when you have a nice complexion and skin ready to go and prepped, then you're more inclined to get different ideas as far as the makeup goes.
Okay.
But again, I mean, there's no real order. You can do it how you choose.
Okay, I'll let you work, Heather. Can you speak when you work, or?
Absolutely, go ahead.
The question I have is, obviously, everybody's gonna have a different shape of eye.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's three major shapes of eyes. Is there, or are there many more than that?
You know, the shape of eye,
but continue working so that we can get you on camera.
There tends to be close. There tends to be a few shapes. You're looking at like an Asian eye, which is more almond shaped.
Mm-hmm.
That is the number one shaped eye that people will recognize when you're talking about an eye shape.
Okay.
There's also not so much that it's a shape, but the different types of set eyes, whether they be closer together, mm-hmm. you know, closer to in toward the nose together, or whether they're farther set apart, if you have more lid to eyebrow ratio, or vice versa.
And what would you do to even it out? Even though, obviously, that's the way it was planned to be.
If you have closer set eyes, mm-hmm. the best thing to do is use a lighter kind of iridescent color towards the inner portion of the eye, mm-hmm. and that will pop that and bring it a little bit more open.
Okay.
If your eyes are further set apart, what you can do is just darken in the crease, and that kind of closes it off.
Okay.
And the same thing, if you have a really tight shut eye and it doesn't open up very well, I would never suggest putting any dark color underneath, because that tends to close your eye even more.
Right.
Whereas if you have a really big eye and you want to make that a little bit smaller, putting a darker liner underneath or even on the wet part of the eye would help give a look of a smaller, more.
And what if you just are really happy with your eye shape? What would
then
you do?
Just have fun. Then sky's the limit. If you know, makeup mm-hmm. is meant to be fun. There's no rule. There are general, you know, ideas of what tends to look best, what you can do and what you shouldn't do, but you know, it's makeup, it's painting, it's fun. It should be whatever you want it to be. As long as you think you look good and as long as it makes you feel comfortable, mm-hmm. there's no right or wrong.
Right. What I'm looking at is the time. This makeup so far has taken, like if we were just to do it 3 minutes,
mm-hmm.
from start to finish of the foundation, the powder, the blush,
yep.
and the eye. To finish this off, what are you going to do for the lip? And you have a little bit of mascara on.
We do have a little bit of mascara on to make this look can be something that you're going out to dinner.
Mm-hmm.
To punch it up even more, all you do is you take a bigger brush.
But this is not finished yet, right?
No, we still have the lip to do and then mascara. But as far as that goes, this is a general look.
So this is a general look right here. Could mm-hmm. we get a camera two? So you would be ready right now to go out, just take your hair down and tossle it, and you're ready to go.
And you're good.
Okay, great. Now we're going to take it over to
a
nighttime look. Okay, thank you.
So all you have to do to take the same look, you don't have to take off what you have.
Mm-hmm.
To add, just use a darker color
mm-hmm.
in the crease of the eye. And what that'll do is it'll just punch it up a little bit, make it a little bit more evening appropriate if you're going out to a club. And again, you know, go as crazy if you want. If you're going to a club, you can add darker and go heavier on the mascara and the eyeliner.
Heather,
yes.
For actors who, you know, they must go out and look good at all times. Mm-hmm. That's like the general rule that people tell you, go out and look good. Look like if somebody sees you, you know, you don't want to really run out without your makeup on, but you want something just light. Is it okay just to go with powder? Just powder and maybe
the essentials that I think a must-have for every woman to have in her purse at all times, that if the only makeup you can do is these few steps, it would be have a powder, mm-hmm. have a lip gloss, and have mascara and blush. Those four
blush
items.
Blush, too.
Blush.
Okay.
Because blush gives a clean, fresh, glowy look to the skin. If you just have powder, it will wash you out. You need the color to make the definitions of the cheeks to the face.
Alrighty. Great. Do you have that in your...
Yeah, she actually just took me shopping and was very upset that I didn't have those things in my makeup bag, so now I do.
Okay, great.
Okay, look out. You just add a little bit to the bottom.
Is this to close her eye or just...
This is just to add a little bit of color.
Okay.
It's not to... Because it's such a light color, it's not going to really do anything other than just add emphasis to the eye.
Gotcha. What about cleaning your makeup? Do you clean it with alcohol?
Close your eyes. When I clean my actual makeup as far as brushes. We're talking about
like
makeup?
Because you took that pencil and outlined her.
Mm-hmm.
You just
What I
it.
Do is I spray it with some isopropyl 90% alcohol.
That you get at a drugstore?
That you can get at any drugstore.
Okay.
And then I just wipe it on a tissue. And the same thing with lipsticks. Being a makeup artist, we never use things out of a tube, with the exception of, eyeliner pencils.
Mm-hmm.
Lipsticks and all that, you put on a little palette, and you never go directly from a tube. Mascara, you have special brushes that you can get disposable brushes to use.
Exactly.
That way you don't cross-contaminate. But if it's your own personal home use, then, use away.
Right. Okay, wonderful. So now she has a smoky look to her eye.
We've
Very
given her
sexy.
A little bit of a smoky look.
Okay.
I'm going to add some lipstick.
And are you going to put more blush on, or is the blush okay?
The blush is good because we already showed that. If she wanted to, we could even maybe add to the blush by adding a little bit of bronzer.
Okay. And that would make it more night or evening?
That would just give another, layer to the skin and another little layer to the makeup.
So not only can you do this very inexpensively, you could do this quickly.
Yes.
This is not something that...
Like if you're at work and you already have your work makeup on, which is generally a clean day look, mm-hmm. as long as you've got some extra blush in your purse and you've got some extra mascara and maybe an eyeliner and some lip gloss, you just put that on and you're good to go. Right from work to the day.
With your husband. Okay. So are we finished? Are we finished with this?
This is going to be a look. The only thing that I would say is just add more mascara.
Want to do that?
Well, yeah, okay. We can do that right now.
And this is one of the Hollywood makeup applications that you were talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so could you just hold that up?
You can have, when I am on set, I obviously can't go from the wand of the original brush back and forth, so we have these handy dandy little disposable wands that you just push in there, and then you put that away and you'll put your original wand right back in there, and now you can use from actor one to actor two to actor three without having to worry because if somebody has pink eye or
you never want to use,
and same with brushes, which are really great because you can clean them with brush cleaner and alcohol to sterilize and sanitize them. And if you needed to, if you only had one brush, you can go from one lip to the next as long as it's being cleaned first.
Wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Look down.
Maybe a lot of people don't know this, but a lot of times on set, the makeup artist will ask the actor to do the mascara themselves. And, it's no problem. Quickly do it. Is there a reason for that? I like it because then I don't get poked in the eye.
Being poked in the eye, a comfort thing. Mm-hmm. They can do it quicker. And sometimes it's weird to have somebody that close to your eye and they just might not like it.
Okay.
So it's just easier for them to do. It's just easier for them to do it. I tend to give them the option.
Okay.
And if they say I'd rather do it, then I let them. If they don't care, then I'll do it for them.
And when they mess up, she just goes in and
cleans it up with a nice little Q-tip
applicator. Because inevitably, you just get like little spots, and it's okay.
And that's hard to avoid, let me tell you. Okay, now look.
Even when she's doing it.
Even when I'm doing it. Mascara is one of those things where everybody inevitably either pokes their eye or gets it on their lid.
Right. Oh, that looks really pretty.
And there you go.
Great. Can we take down your hair and kind of ruffle it just to give it the finished look?
If you really want to, okay. I don't think it's going to do what you want.
I think it will. You want to help me out here?
Sprayed it.
Then it's going to even look better. You got to flip it.
Go ahead and put your head down and flip.
We kind of sprayed it a little bit.
Still looks really pretty. You sprayed it like that. Here we go. Now you have like the tousled sexy look.
Yes.
Great. Okay, and you're ready to go out.
There we go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And we'll be back with you